Okay, here we are back in Legend of Heroes Trails of Cold Steel. Where we last left off, we did our free day, it's practical exam time, and then we will be following up with our newest field study. So I'm gonna go quiet as the scene plays out, and I'll pick up when the duel commences.
Don't you dare hold back!
So since we dealt with the training robot earlier on, this time we have to do a two-on-two fight against Laura and Fie. So you have to win without items, and you have to use an S-craft at some point during the battle. It doesn't have to kill or anything like that, you just have to use it. So, to be blunt, this fight is extremely easy, and if you want to make it a little bit more personal, you could have Machias as your partner, because there will be a rematch later on. I think it's even in this video. So, they cannot link, they can't really do anything impressive, and it's just a good old-fashioned beatdown. You can see Laura is sealed, and she's going to spend the majority of the fight like that while I just focus down Fie.
My turn.
Now, the thing is, Fie has such low HP that her hands are pretty much tied. There's nothing she can do. And in Laura's case, her hands are essentially literally tied. So, Laura, as you may have guessed, is extremely physical focused, and as a result, Seal is just crippling to her. So, if you were to believe her in the Suzaku courts, hopefully this has convinced you.
I was careless.
So, Fee's down, Laura still can't do a damn thing to defend herself. I'm popping the
gavel on my plate.
So I used the S-Craft because the condition required it. You saw the condition met pop up. So now the only order of business left is to finish off Laura before she gets unsealed.
Here we go!
And that's that, folks. It really was that easy.
Wasn't strong enough.
That's that. Let's keep moving.
No quartz is a, or no seventh is a payout, sadly.
Thank you. on up. Here's a little something from the Academy. You did really well, Rean.
This is our chance to discuss what to do before they get here. But to be honest, I don't really have any good ideas. How about you guys?
I can't say that I do. Unlike me and Eusis, at least Laura and Fie understand each other to some degree. Our group's performance in last month's field study wasn't amazing, but there were no actual conflicts or anything.
Yeah, that's all the more reason why I feel like we should step in and do something for them. But from what Elisa and Emma have told me, it seems like they have trouble connecting with each other.
Yeah, that's the impression I get, too. It's not like they hate each other. They're just having trouble coming to terms with their differences.
On the one hand, we have the daughter of a noble military family. A knight in shining armor, as it were. While on the other, we have a girl who spent her childhood on the battlefield running with Jaegers. Their upbringings couldn't be more different when you think about it. Maybe their values, too.
You're right. I wonder if that's...
I apologize for the delay.
Hey! Good morning, Laura.
My, you're certainly the early bird today.
You needn't worry about us. We have no intention of causing trouble, and we're prepared to do what we can to form a combat link as soon as possible. It's not our intention to be confrontational towards one another. Is that not the case, Fie?
Yep. Don't worry. We won't bring the group down during the field study.
Well, if you say so.
That's not really what we're worried about.
Anyway, we should finish up our preparations and head over to the station. I'll bet Group B's waiting there for us already.
Agreed.
So I'm popping up here to actually show off that we set up the Selene quest properly this time so we get our reward. There'll be a little bit of banter back and forth between Rean and the cat, and eventually we'll get our prize. And I'll show what it does just in case you're not familiar with the series, but we have our Zerum powder. And there is a scene with Patrick that I'll show off in a moment. Definitely worth seeing if just for the novelty value. But right there you can see cures KO, all HP, gives you 100 CP, nothing for EP, sadly. But that's basically the game's equivalent to an elixir. And here's the scene with Patrick.
exactly on time.
Huh?
Wait, what?
Hear that?
You're from the Railway Military Police, if memory serves me correctly.
You're Captain Claire, was it?
That's right. I'm glad you remember me. I believe it's been about 3 months since we last met.
So, this must be the woman the group who went to Keldic encountered.
So this is an officer from the fearsome RMP?
Since you're here, does that mean you're going to be the one assigning our tasks for this month's field study?
No, I'm just here to provide a place for you to talk with the person who is. He should be here any moment now. Here he comes.
Perfect timing.
No way.
Dad?
Huh.
I've seen him in the Imperial Chronicle before.
Governor Regnitz, one of the Reformists' most influential voices.
So this is Machias' father.
This is the first time I've met most of you, so let me introduce myself. I'm Carl Regnitz, Machias' father. I'm the governor of Heimdall and head of the local government. It's a pleasure to finally meet you, ladies and gentlemen of Class 7.
Thank you.
Isn't this...
Oh, this is where they published the Imperial Chronicle newspaper.
So if you want to upgrade your weapons like I do here, the best person to upgrade is Laura. And if you have enough mirror lying around, you can actually pick up a second weapon to upgrade. The second best person to upgrade is Machias, and you'll see why when we go into the sewer. But Laura will help for a fight later on, and then Machias will just be amazing at clearing out the mobs since he hits level 34 and unlocks his next craft. So... like I said, Laura is top priority, number two being Machias, and you have to look at what resources you have on hand and plan accordingly. By the way, for equipment, just general, like, armor stuff, I'd say Machias should have... Yeah, it's just Machias and Laura should get the priority. Pretty much for the exact same reasons I mentioned, even in terms of armor. Specifically stuff that gives them speed, because that will make your fights even easier and faster.
Thank you.
Here's the statue of Emperor Dreykles. He strikes quite a stately pose.
Weird to think he's the one who founded our academy.
Oh my.
Lady Clotilde, is it time for you to depart?
Yes, I'll be stepping out for a while. But more importantly, who do we have here?
Is that... No way!
Vita Clotilde?
Whoa! I can't believe it! It's really her!
I never thought I'd actually get the chance to meet her.
You three, don't just stand there staring. You're in the presence of the legendary opera singer Vita Clotilde, the Azure Diva herself!
The Azure Diva, huh? I do recall hearing that name at some point.
Wait, you don't know who she is?
I'm not surprised. Opera is a world unto itself. I expect there are multitudes who have never heard of me before. I'm Vita Clotilde, an opera singer. I'd be delighted if you would come and hear me sing sometime.
Trigger chest! Oh, a treasure chest!
Oh, what a nice looking treasure chest.
This would make a great training area. I envy the people who live around here.
Only you would see an underground passage and think about training.
Is that a treasure chest?
Oh, what a nice looking treasure chest.
So you may have noticed the off-color treasure chest. You know what that means. It's monster busting time.
Enemies ahead!
So they throw a lot of enemies at you, and at this point of the game, this is completely meaningless. You can shred them like it's nothing. So right here, make sure everyone is set for the detector. Once I know that is the case, then it's just choose a group and make them very, very happy.
My turn!
So with Rean, you have access to Gale.
Second form, Gale! Another chance!
An opening!
Now, you may ask, why would you still use Autumn Leaf Cutter once you have that? Simple reason being, that does not impede, Leafcutter does. And here's Machias's mob buster move. It inflicts Petrify. So even though some of those guys aren't actually dead in terms of HP, they can't do anything anymore. They're done. And the move is AoE, it's strong to begin with. It's just really, really overpowered. So at this point, the only resistance left are the two petrified guys, and they can't do anything, so this is the end of the fight.
There.
Using Autumn Leaf Cutter because I'll get the CP back for the executes.
Okay, it's safe for now.
And that was a piece of cake, right? Now our reward here, I believe, is Genbu.
A plus outcome.
Not bad.
Yes, so this inflicts poison and petrify on your moves. I go ahead and put this on Machias. I don't know if it's a waste or not, because I don't know how this works when you actually use this petrify craft. I don't know if it actually boosts the chance of petrify, if it's plus 10%, or if it's another petrify roll, this one being a 10% roll compared to his craft, which is something like a 20 or 30, I think. But there is a possibility that just one could take priority over the other, with the lower priority one being ignored entirely. That is a possibility. I can't make any promises. As for Genbu itself, that is the ox turtle of the north in Feng Shui. Sometimes it's represented by a bull or an ox, sometimes a turtle. And neat bit of trivia for you guys, if you ever wondered what the hell Bowser is from the Mario series, he's actually a cartoon depiction of the mythical beast Genbu. So, if you're trying to figure out what it looks like, you can always think of Bowser. The more you know.
challenging foe.
Here's
our extermination. So with the new moves in our pocket, you can guess that this is not going to be much of an issue. I will start things off with a resounding beat, because I don't know if I'm getting into this fight just yet. Sadly, Fie does not have any CP handy to actually start using crafts. And the little small fry enemies are immune to Earth, so I can't use the one offensive spell she does have.
Right.
Now, unfortunately, the radius on Radiant Dance actually isn't really that big, and as a result, I can't really get a lot of enemies with it. Earth Cleaver, on the other hand, actually is a better move to use, I think, because it has the stat specs that come with it. In case you're wondering why I chose to pop the Rush there, that does give CP to Fie, even if it's just one extra round. Now that's the move. I think that's the only move I ever see the slime thing use. I don't know if it does have anything else or what.
Second form, Gale!
We'll spam Gale.
Go! I'll pick you up!
And you can see one of the enemies over there is frozen. That is from Laura's Seiryu ports. So in case you ever wonder why I really like these stats effect ports, I've been using them since Trails in the Sky. It's for moments like these.
Here.
So there goes the flash grenade. Sadly, Fie is far, far from being optimized on my team, and thus her DPS really does suffer as a result. I don't know what stats effect was going to play to stop the boss from casting or doing something, but it was a stats effect that didn't allow him to move. Sadly, the hydro cannon is going to go to waste. I should have fired it down the right side. I wasn't actually anticipating killing the slimes this easily. But once again, we have the link break that will be coming back at the end of day. In case you're wondering, I'm swinging over here because if you do drop a stat effect on the enemy, it will stop the spell. It's an alternate to impede. It's just I didn't actually anticipate killing the thing. So, yeah. So use Autumn Leaf Cutter there to execute the one enemy. We also got a little bit of chip damage on the boss.
My turn.
In case you're wondering, Fie does have impede versus similar to Autumn Leaf Cutter. And you can see, slowly but surely, the enemy's getting worked out. isolation. Suffers the recounter 10, but that wasn't too impactful. And I use Flame Art here because it's a 0 R turn and the thing is really weak to Fire Element. Takes out a nice little chunk. By the way, you will be losing Rean after this fight, so don't be afraid to burn up all of his EP. There also is a rest point right outside of here, so if you use the other character's EP, they can get it back right there. So after Wiz turned in Laura into position since she got knocked further and further back with her spatial oscillation knockbacks. And right here is trying to see if they can form a link with someone else. But no, once their link's severed, they can't partner with anyone else. They have to sit there without it for the rest of the fight. Lame, I know.
And it was an enemy attack at it.
So I'm using Detector here so that Rean and Elliot can still get link attacks, but it doesn't help the girls in any which way.
My turn! Shatter!
Here we go!
So, nice little chunk of damage. The enemy has reduced defense, so I can't punish. In case you're wondering, the heal is Rean, it's not the slime healing up that much HP after every round or anything like that. If that were the case, it really would take forever to kill this boss.
Go!
My turn.
Right! Focus activate!
And this is the tedious part.
Shatter!
It's hard to say whether or not I would have been better off leaving Laura on the bench. Well, you can't actually. The only one you can bench here is either Elliot or Machias. So yeah, that actually isn't even an option.
My turn.
Arcus activate.
To be blunt, I'm just not a fan of Fie.
My turn.
You'll see some of the things she can do as we progress through the day.
Here we go! Arcus, activate!
In case you're wondering, the last fight of the day, I believe we have to use her and Laura. Really, really annoying fight.
Of course!
And as we're here, sadly, there really isn't that much to talk about. It's just, the fight is effectively over. I just have to cut through what's left of the enemy's HP because they have a lot more than they probably need. And their defenses are kind of high considering just how high their HP is. All in all, it leads to a really drawn out fight. Then again, spatial oscillation could be dangerous if they were maybe a little bit weaker. Perhaps on lower level games it's an issue, but here, not so much.
Here we go!
So you can see a channeling, Laura cannot impede, but Fie can, so we just have to wait for her turn to come around.
Shatter!
My turn.
Target locked.
So it looked right there he got fainted, but he healed before I could actually do anything.
Go!
Well, we also got burn in effect, so that will help shave off quite a bit of HP.
Go! I'll take you up! Arcus activate!
So the enemy has 400 hit points left, I just have to deliver the finishing blow.
Okay.
but he dies to the flame, and that's it. 2.2 EXP mod. So you can see who all leveled up, but we will be swapping the party around since Rean is leaving. Even though I finally got forced to level 4. Heartbreaking, I know.
Alright!
Done.
Not bad.
An A-plus outcome.
Is that a treasure chest?
There's a light.
The sound's getting louder too.
We must be getting close to the exit now.
Thank you.
This is incredible.
He could open a shop with all the instruments here.
A piano, violins, wind instruments, a robust percussion section. I'm assuming the papers in the cabinet are all sheet music.
There's no way you can call this just a hobby.
Yeah, coming in here, this must look like some rabid obsession to you guys. You know, my mom was a pretty famous pianist. Being raised around music like that, my sister and I ended up sharing her love of music.
Really?
Looking at all this, I can see why you decided to join the wind orchestra at the academy.
Still, why didn't you go to the same school as the people we met earlier?
Fie?
Wait, Fie, that's not...
Don't worry about it. I'm sure this comes as no surprise. But I'd originally planned to attend the music academy.
Oh.
My sister and I grew up listening to our mom play the piano. Dad was more the strong, stoic type. He didn't know much about music, but he was head over heels in love with her. Our home was always filled with the sound of music, and it kept our family smiling together. But 7 years ago, Mom got really ill. Eventually, she passed away. After her death, my sister and I both wanted to follow in her footsteps. She enrolled at the music academy and began working toward a career as a pianist. Naturally, I tried to do the same, but Dad wouldn't hear of it. It's one thing to have it as a hobby, but the idea of a man of the Empire making his living through music is absurd. No matter how hard I tried to convince him, he just shook his head and refused to listen. Then he started recommending one military academy after another, trying to push me toward a career in the army. Eventually, I didn't have much choice. I had to give up my dream of attending the music academy. I hated him for it. I really did. I'm no good at fighting, never have been. I'd get smoked in a real war. But after some research, I found one academy, Thor's, offered plenty of music-related classes. And that about half of its graduates end up in careers outside the military. In the end, I met him halfway and chose to enroll at Thor's. Kinda pathetic, huh? You've all got great reasons why you're there at the academy. Then there's me, who'd rather be on a stage than a battlefield. But I couldn't go against my dad. For a while, I started to think that maybe my passion for music had kind of cooled off. But I'm still full of regrets about the Music Academy and the summer festival concert, so I guess it hasn't after all. Oh, I wish I could just crawl into a hole right now.
So that's how you ended up at Thor's.
I had no idea.
Do you regret it? Coming to Thor's and all?
Huh? Of course not. Why would I?
Huh?
So you don't?
Life at the academy keeps me busy, but I still have time to perform with the wind orchestra after class is out. And I feel like I really broaden my horizons every time we go on a field study. Honestly, I feel like I get more out of Thor's than if I had just enrolled at the music academy without much thought. Maybe it's because whether I decide I want to be a musician or do something else totally different, I'll at least have the chance to choose what I want without someone deciding for me.
Elliot.
Wow, you've really given this a lot of thought.
You really are strong, Elliot.
I wish I thought so too. I still feel jealous when I see my friends who went to the music academy putting their heart and soul into their music. But even with that, I've got no regrets about coming to Thor's. None at all. Besides, if I hadn't come, I never would have met you guys, would I? I'd regret that way more.
How can you say that with a straight face?
Maybe he's just oblivious.
I didn't think I was saying anything particularly embarrassing.
I figured that most people would blush saying something like that.
Still, this is Elliot we're talking about. He can get away with it.
You're the last person who should be saying that, Rean. Actually, I just remembered. I guess I do have one regret after all.
Oh?
What is it?
remember the summer festival concert my friend said they're going to be performing in? Back when my mom was still alive, she performed in it, and my sister played in it 5 years ago, too. So I was really hoping that I'd be able to take the stage there one day, too.
What a pleasant evening.
It's pretty relaxing.
No denying those two have some surprising similarities.
All right, Fie. Here are my conditions. If I win this duel, I want you to tell me about your past, your personal history. At first, there was something about your strength that I couldn't bring myself to accept. From the moment we first met, I could tell you were holding back, and considering your build, your combat proficiency is extraordinary. It's simply too far removed from what I've come to know through following the way of the sword.
No doubt.
To add to that, you were once part of a Jaeger Corps. I can't say I've ever thought of the Jaegers in a particularly favorable light. If one defines knighthood as the way of the virtuous, how can the path of the Jaeger be seen as anything but corrupt? I came to believe that because we'd been raised with such strongly opposing values, I could not accept you. However, I was mistaken. After hearing Elliot's story, I asked myself again why it was that I felt such resistance to fighting alongside you. I tried to ascertain my own feelings, slowly and carefully. And that was when I finally realized, during all these months we spent together, I've known deep down that you were worthy of my trust. Our values had nothing to do with that judgment. It came from my heart alone. But in my stubbornness, I refused to acknowledge that one simple truth. In my heart, I had already deemed you worthy of trust. Yet in my mind, I still couldn't see past our incompatibilities. I suspect that contradiction was what prevented us from using our Arcus to fight as one.
You aren't the only one who thought we couldn't get along. You live your life so honestly. I guess somewhere along the way I'd given up on you ever accepting me.
I see.
Still, what does this have to do with wanting to know about my past? Why do you want to know?
It's very simple, really. I want to know because I like you.
What are you?
I find it frustrating when I'm not able to understand those I've taken an interest in or have a high opinion of. I felt like this several months ago with Rean, and I feel the same way now. That's why I want to know your history. I want to know what shaped you into who you are now. That said, this is simply an act of self-indulgence on my part. Nothing more, nothing less.
You really are something else. It's fine. I don't mind telling you. But taking your spoils by force is the Jaeger's way through and through. Is that okay with you?
It's fine. Because I have no intention of thinking of my reward as a spoil of battle. I'd much rather consider it an honor, bestowed for a hard-won
victory. Fine by me.
You just talk things out. Why do you even need to fight now?
All right, I'll officiate your duel. Neither of you need to hold anything back. If I think it's getting too dangerous, I'll step in and stop the fight.
Very well.
Thanks.
Go!
Shatter!
Target locked. Here.
Impressive.
Same to you.
Then I won't hold back. Allow me to show my strongest skill learned from my father.
Then I'll show you my strongest. Learned from the boss himself.
That's enough!
I couldn't even tell who won. What about you, Rean?
I feel bad saying this after volunteering to be the judge, but as far as I could tell, it was a draw.
Really?
Well, I suppose it is what it is. I'll simply have to continue my training and challenge you again another time. And don't forget, I still wish to duel you as well.
Wait, why me?
Honestly.
Actually, I lost this one.
Huh?
Jaegers are at our best when we fight at night. The darkness gives us an edge. But even after I threw out a flash grenade, the duel still ended in a draw. If we'd fought during the day, I would have lost.
That's...
She has a point.
Well then.
Very well. I'll accept this victory.
Hmm.
Well, anyway, I guess the two of us should go for a little stroll then.
I don't mind if you listen. Is that fine with you, Laura?
I have no objections. We're all in this together.
Okay. I used to be part of a Jaeger Corps called Zephyr. Before that, my earliest memories are of explosions and battlefields. I found myself wandering in a war-torn hotspot on the outskirts of some country I never even knew the name of. Jaeger Corps threw themselves into battle for the highest bidder day after day, while I wandered alone. The man who eventually took me in called himself the Jaeger King. He was the leader of Zephyr, a pretty famous Jaeger Corps. He was middle-aged, crafty, stubborn, and lucky. He always seemed so carefree, but he never let his guard down. To me, though, he was the closest thing to a father I've ever had. The other members of Zephyr had their quirks, but they were all nice to me. As time went on, I started helping with the cleaning, the cooking, the packing. During my free time, they started teaching me all kinds of skills I'd need to survive on the battlefield. One thing led to another, and I ended up fighting in my first real battle. I was 10, I think. The boss was reluctant, but after the others persuaded him, he made me a full-fledged member of the group. For the next few years, we lived and fought together. I even picked up a nickname like some career Jaegers do. Sylphied. We roamed all across the continent together. There were hard times. Times when we thought we might not live through the night, but we always did. Together. Until last year, when our boss died. It was a clash with another Jaeger Corps. The Red Constellation. People used to say they were the only other Jaeger Corps in West Zemuria who could match us. Their leader, a guy they called the War God, had been on bad terms with our boss for years. Eventually, the War God and the Jaeger King decided to settle things with one big duel. They kept going for 3 days and 3 nights. In the end, they both fell. After that, the Zephyr I'd grown up with disbanded. All the members who were left just kind of scattered. I don't know where they went. Then, just like that, I was alone again.
For the final fight of the chapter. This time we're playing from the other side. So, from my experience, this was an RNG fight. Simple being is, this is where I used some retries, because I played through this, trying to fight them like conventional enemies, and I don't know what it is, but they have sky-high evasion. So much so that even in one round, I couldn't touch them before they killed everyone. case in point, if you see Rean just dodge two things. I don't know what determines what he can and can't do.
Hang in there, everyone!
To make things worse, if you look at the energy shell, that's still a percent HP heal. So the only way I can figure out to win this fight is with Scud Ripper.
Here we go.
Boom, Deathblow to Machias.
Now, an opening!
So that took care of Rean's healing, but he's still really, really strong.
Alright, let's do this!
So my solution to that...
I'll handle it.
You guessed it. You'll see it in a second.
Okay.
Scud Ripper.
Here we go.
And another death.
Should have seen that coming.
This was the smoothest I could get the fight to go, and still, it was all RNG. I don't know if there's a way to bring them down to something manageable, but unless you've really invested into these two, this is an extremely difficult fight. All things considered, I think you're best off just abusing Scud Ripper.
Up in the world. I've got a little reward here for you. Drinks are on me
and
someday.
That's it for now. So, we're done. I'll see you next time. I'm the Hero of Light. Thanks for watching, and goodbye.